Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm currently prepping for Stanford's writing competition. I'm honestly just so ready to get this over with because I've been so busy with law school and law related things these past few weeks. I just feel so drained and like dull physically. Like I feel like my hair, my skin, my body is just like not in a good place because of how little time I've been able to commit to taking care of myself, which I really don't like. I don't like that reality, but once I do this, I'll have like a month and a half just to myself. I'm very much looking forward to, I think I need that to recharge before I start at Stanford. This is like my last push, hopefully, unless anything else comes up. I wanted to talk a little bit about the difference between Stanford's writing competition and Penn's writing competition. I am, you know, a little bit less excited that I have to do this because I've already done a writing competition. Things happen, so here we are. I think the biggest adjustment for me going through this process has been that Stanford has like its own version of the Blue Book. Which I showed you guys in my last video. I have it right here. And this is just like the legal citation form. They have their own version called the Red Book. They're the only school I know of that does that. And it is similar to the Blue Book, but they like make their own corrections, changes, things like that when they feel like something isn't clear in the Blue Book or they just don't agree with the rule. So I have to like learn that and like erase what I memorized for Penn's out of my mind, which is like frustrating. I just went ahead and like read through their entire document that they gave me, which was like 30 pages of just like citation rules. Not to memorize it, but just because I do have a good memory. So I feel like when I am like going through a citation, I'll know, oh, I read about that. So I know that it's a rule that I need to look up, which will be helpful, I think. Also, a difference between Penn's writing competition and Stanford's writing competition is that Stanford lets you like use the online version of the Blue Book or the Red Book, whatever, whereas Penn didn't. You have to use the physical copy. I think there are pros and cons to both of those things. One, like I'm going to be able to use the online version in the real world, so I get why I'm allowed to use it on the writing competition. If I was allowed to do that, I don't think I would have ever opened my hard copy when I was doing the writing competition the first time. But now I am like very comfortable with this hard copy because I've tabbed it so that I know where and how to find things relatively quickly. And honestly, like it takes me a little bit longer to like know what to search on the online version. So like that's a little bit of an adjustment as well. I am going to be doing some practice footnote corrections for the next maybe hour or so, and then I'm gonna see how that goes, and then maybe I might do a real one today. We'll see. I have until August 20th to finish. It's currently the 7th, so I have time, but like I said, I really need to rest and rejuvenate, and I'm not gonna be able to do that if this is hanging over my head. So I'm really trying to get it over as soon as possible. The other thing that I don't like about Stanford's compared to Penn is that this writing competition is only for law review. There's not a ranking system like there was at Penn. So like I could do all of this work and then not be on a journal at the end and have to direct apply to a different journal, which is very frustrating because if I do all of this, like I want to be on a journal at the end and I might not be. That's really annoying. Like I knew that even if I didn't do that well on Penn's writing competition, I would still get a journal. It would just not be law review. Here, if I don't do well, I don't get a journal and I don't get law review. That's sad to think about. Okay, I'm gonna just get started now so that I can hopefully finish this. I also have an interview, a callback interview for a firm I really want tomorrow. So there's just a lot going on as always. And I just can't wait for the next few days to be over so I can just take care of myself.
I just finished my last interview.
Okay guys, I started the test, the writing, the edit, whatever. I started it last night.
I hope that you
So now I have like 5.5 days to complete it, and it's a lot longer than I thought it was gonna be. Cause the examples were just like, edit this footnote for practice, blah, blah, whatever. But the thing is like, I got a whole article. It's an actual article, and I have to edit the text and the footnotes and site check all in one document, whereas on the practice it's separated out the different things. Kind of annoying, but anyway, I just finished my first read through. I started last night, I finished it today because it's 17 pages single space. Did I say that? Anyway, and I just did like some basic corrections over things that I knew and flagged things that I thought might be wrong but wasn't sure. So now I'm gonna go back and read that again, and then I'm gonna go through the footnotes, and then I'm gonna do the site checks. Have no idea how long this is gonna take, but hopefully less than 6 days. Something everyone can see. I just finished my second go through of the body text of this thingy, this article, and now I have to start the footnotes, which are actually going to take forever. Correcting these footnotes is going to take a very long time. There's so many of them. And unlike Penn's writing competition, where I was just pressed for time and just, you know, fix things as I saw them, I actually have to go through and fix everything about these footnotes, which is going to take a very long time. I'm probably not gonna start that till tomorrow. Hi guys, it's Tuesday night. I have been working on my footnotes for 3 hours now, and I'm approximately 18% done. That's showing you how long this is taking. I think I'm gonna work all night tonight and all day tomorrow and all day the next day. So please keep me in your thoughts and prayers. Hey guys, so I just had dinner at 9:30 and now it's 10, and I'm about to start my late night shift. So I'm really excited. I want to get through, let's say half of the footnotes before I go to sleep. Wish me luck, and I'll keep you updated. It's 11:37. I'm 27% done. I'm about to take a shower to take a break, and then I'm going to come back. Hey guys, I'm all fresh and clean. It's 12:08 a.m. I'm feeling good. It's time to get back into it. I'm losing steam. It's 1:23 a.m. I'm 36% finished, which is not 50, but I think I'm about to go to sleep because I can't do this anymore. I'm just gonna work all day tomorrow. It's 12:44 p.m. and I'm just now starting. Giving you guys an update, it's 3:12 and I'm halfway through all of the citations. So this is where I wanted to be last night, and I'm just now getting here at 3:12 on Wednesday. Hello guys, I am well into my night shift. It's 10:30 p.m. on the dot. I'm pretty close. I'm like, hold on, let me do some math. I'm 77% done. I literally have to finish the footnotes today because I feel like it's gonna take a long time to do the site checking. Like making sure that the sources are saying what the authors are saying they're saying. I'm hoping that goes by faster than I'm expecting it to, but I expect that that's gonna take a long time, which means I'm gonna need all day tomorrow to do it because I'm going out of town on Friday. And then also this, I only have like 2.5 more days before I'm out of time. Hi guys, it's midnight. I still have at least a couple hours before I'm finished. I'm not like sleepy, but my brain needed a break. I just started getting lazy and making mistakes that I shouldn't be making. So I took a step away. I'm gonna go on TikTok, gonna eat some ice cream, and then hopefully in like 20 minutes, I can start fresh again. It's 2:20 a.m. I switched from blue booking to doing the site checking, and I don't know if I was just really getting tired of the blue booking, but the site checking is way more fun for my brain. That's good. I'm actually already over halfway through, which is very comforting because that means I won't have to do this all day tomorrow, at least not actively. Like, I might still be reviewing it all day, but I won't be like putting stuff in all day. I'm about to go to sleep, probably gonna wake up around 9:30.
Hi guys, it's 1:30 on Thursday. I just finished the site checking portion of the competition, so that's super good. That means I only have to finish the footnotes that I didn't do last night, and then I'll be done. Having gone through everything, and then of course I'm going to check everything endlessly until I'm out of time.
Guys, it's 11:45 p.m. on Thursday and I have one citation left. Please pray for me. Hey guys, it's Tuesday of the following week and I don't remember if I filmed this, so I finished the editing portion of my writing competition on Saturday and I turned it in. That's good. After I like finished the last footnote that I was working on, I went back and I reread the rules and I flagged anything that I feel like I might have missed or that I knew I did incorrectly. Like there were some small like, oh, I should have hyphenated like this way and I'm pretty sure I hyphenated that way, or I need to make sure that I put a non-breaking space in between these numbers because I'm not sure that I did. So I made sure to flag like little things like that that I thought I might miss, so that when I then went through and reread everything to proofread, like those things would stand out to me, and I double checked all of those. It took me a couple hours. Then I was just like, okay, I've done what I can. I'm turning it in. So I turned it in. Now I have to do the writing portion of the competition, which is the most foreign to me because I didn't have to do anything like this for Penn's, but basically I have to read like a sample article that we are deciding to publish and then write a substantive memo to the author of the piece saying, we like this article, here's how we substantively think that you could improve upon it. So I hope that the article's on something that like I'm at least a little bit familiar with, because then I think that I'll be able to more easily give like substantive suggestions. If it's not, then this is gonna be really annoying. But I only have 2 days to do this part, whereas I had 6 days to do the last one. So regardless, it'll be over soon, which I'm grateful for. Then I just have to do my personal statement, which I already have one. So that should be fine. I also don't know how long this article is going to be that I have to read, so hopefully it's not super long, but I have a feeling it's going to be close to 20 pages like the last one was. Okay, well I'm about to get started, so I will keep you guys updated. Guys, it's been 2 hours and I've barely done anything because this article is so boring and it's twice as long as I thought it was going to be, and I fell asleep. I'm about to sit on the floor and do it so that it'll be harder for me to fall asleep. Okay guys, so last night I just started writing and started making some stuff up. I've written about 500 words, a little over 500 out of the 1,000 that I'm supposed to write in this memo. It's bad. I know that it's bad. But if I can just get some okay ideas out there, I can spin it to sound good. I just need to get the ideas on the page.
2 weeks later.
Just got the call that I made law review at Stanford! Yeah!